What's going on, everybody? Matthew Monis here, and right in front of me I have the brand new Lenovo Yoga C930. This looks a lot like the more or less recent Yoga 730. And you're probably asking yourself, Matt, what are you doing bringing the same laptop on the channel? Well, it's not. It's different. There's a lot of key features inside of here that basically make it different from any laptop on the market. Now, first things first, the design. It's pretty much the exact same looking laptop as the 730, but as you can see here, the hinge system is a little bit different. Where on the 730, you get one on opposite ends. On the 930, you get one long one that basically spans the back of the laptop and a smaller one on the left-hand side. And I'll tell you why shortly. Besides that, the edges are still very sharp, not nearly as sharp as the 730, but sharp enough that they should be sanded out or a little bit smoother in future releases. Weight, 3 pounds or 1.36 kilograms, making this very light to keep in your bag for school, for office professionals, anybody who's basically out all day and doesn't want to carry a heavy design. Now you can get this in iron gray, which is the color I have here, and there's a second option, which is more similar to the 730. But the crazy thing about this laptop is the fact that there's a pen inside of here. On the back, there is a pen stored inside. Think of this laptop as the Galaxy Note 9 of ultrabooks. You see, Microsoft Surface has been doing a great job by including a magnet on the side of the laptop to store your pen. But the fact that you're actually storing it in the laptop just makes my life so much easier. The port setup is very similar to the 730, except for one key thing. On the left-hand side, you have a USB 3.0 port, two USB Type-C Thunderbolt 3 ports, so you can hook it up to an external GPU, and an audio jack. On the right-hand side, you have no ports, and that's because there is the pen, which is stored back here, and they had to remove the extra USB 3.0 port. The C930 is one of the more easier laptops to open up, and not much is really upgradable. You have the M2 NVMe SSD. This is swappable. You can replace it with a 2 terabyte NVMe drive if you really want to down the road. You have a 60 watt hour battery spanning the bottom of the laptop. This will net you 7 to 8 hours of use before needing to charge. And this is just doing simple productivity, browsing the web, all the standard stuff that most people do with their laptops. You have a swappable Wi-Fi card. If you're not liking the one that's in here, you can swap it out for something else. But based on my experience, it's been pretty solid. You have two fans cooling the CPU and integrated GPU. I think it's a fantastic setup. They have it on opposite ends to provide a pretty good cooling solution. And finally, the pen slot. This is a great way to see what it looks like. There's a little mechanism on the bottom that lets it slide in. It attaches to a magnet that clicks, providing a secure place for it. Now you're probably wondering, where's the RAM? Well, it's either soldered onto the motherboard on the opposite side of the laptop. You can only put up to 16 gigabytes inside of here. So whatever model you do choose, make sure it has the amount of RAM you want it to. Now, because this is a convertible laptop, you can pretty much rotate the display 360 degrees. So you can put it in tablet mode, which is great for writing and sketching. You can throw it in tent mode, which is great for watching movies. You can put it in traditional laptop mode to type up documents or flip the screen all the way around like this to use it as a touch interface. This is a 14-inch display, it is IPS, this is full HD, but you can also buy this with a 4K panel. Now the other thing to note is the pen. It's 4,096 levels of pressure, really low latency, so writing and drawing on this is an absolute joy. The 720p webcam up top actually has a camera shutter. So this basically means when you're not using the camera, you can simply slide it over and block access to the camera. So if you're obsessed with good external sound and you want it in an ultrabook, this is the laptop to get. What Lenovo did was place two speakers on the bottom of the laptop and two speakers in the hinge. Because it supports Dolby Atmos with the external speakers, you get this 3D sound stage that completely envelops you. It's one of the most interesting sound experiences I've ever had on an ultrabook. Also, because the hinge has the speakers in them, no matter what position the laptop is in, the sound is always facing you. So if you're someone who wants great sound on their ultrabook, who travels a lot, and doesn't have to plug in headphones, this is the laptop to take a look at. Keyboard, very similar to the Y730, so nothing to report there. It's using the U-shaped keys with pretty decent travel distance. And same holds true for the touchpad. It's using Windows Precision drivers, it's a good size, and overall, no complaints with accuracy. Now, if you want Windows Hello, you do have the fingerprint scanner on the bottom right, and this will get you in pretty quick. Performance is pretty amazing on this laptop. I mean, you're not gonna be playing the latest games on this. In fact, this is not a gaming laptop, but it's a productivity-based machine. And just like the Y730, you're gonna get very similar results. results. The i7-8550U is a great U-series processor that will basically give you good battery efficiency with some pretty great performance. Productivity, having tons of tabs open, working in Microsoft Office, doing a little bit of light Photoshop is no problem for this laptop. If you do want it to game, you can play some of the older titles, maybe Overwatch if you drop down the settings to low. But besides that, it's a productivity machine. Heat management, fantastic. Because it has two fans and there's a lot of space for the heat to leave the laptop, you're getting some pretty good surface temperatures of around 41 to 45 degrees Celsius. Even when I ran my tests for like 30 or 40 minutes, the CPU temps never surpassed 77 degrees Celsius. When it comes to fan noise, it's generally low. Even when this thing is maxed out, this is the i7 version, it doesn't get loud enough to really complain. So if you're in a class or if you're in a library and you want your laptop to stay quiet, the C930 does a great job. So here are my closing thoughts. I really dig the C930. It may be only a slightly more refined 730, but the fact that this sound is so good when you listen to it makes this a much more appealing product. And the pen, the fact that you can store it in the laptop is a great way for peace of mind. I don't care if you have a holster, a great magnet, you're still gonna lose it, you're still gonna knock it off somewhere and forget it behind. Think of this as the Galaxy Note 9 of laptops. I don't ever have to worry about buying batteries, and I don't have to ever worry about charging my pen because it's gonna do it automatically when I place it inside of the laptop. Anyways, that wraps up this review of the C930. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Hit me up on Discord if you have any questions. Follow me on Instagram for some behind the scenes, and I'll see you guys in the next one.